Hey guys, what's up? It's Matt over to Common Idiot, and yesterday some leaked images from the upcoming movie The Batman came out, and it kind of caused a little bit of controversy within the fans. So if you don't know anything about this movie, Matt Reeves is going to be directing this, and it's going to be released next year. The Batman, the main villain in this movie, is going to be the Riddler. I believe it's going to be about year two, so it's again another origin story, which I'm kind of just over already. I'm tired of seeing Batman's origin story, but it is what it is. So the main villain is going to be the Riddler, and they are going to have Selina Kyle, aka Catwoman, will also be in it as well. So the controversy is what the Riddler looks like. From what I've seen, it's a mixed bag. People either love it or they hate it. So let me scroll down here and show you what I'm talking about, what leaked. So it looked like a calendar leaked, and here's the picture blown up. So obviously it has multiple for all the months in the year. A lot of them are showcasing the Batmobile. Now, I don't know how I feel about this Batmobile yet. It looks personally to me like something the Punisher would be driving. It looks just like an up-armored 69 Camaro, something like that. But I don't know. I guess it makes sense if it's year two. He's not going to have some giant up-armored vehicle yet, but I don't know. I'm just kind of in between. I have a really love for vehicles and cars, and I love the Batmobile. Well, some of them. I love some of those Batmobiles, and I don't know. This, I definitely don't love it, but I'm not going to say I hate it yet. So, Robert Pattinson's suit so far looks okay. It looks something to me like out of the video games. The Arkham series, that's what it reminds me of, at least. I just always thought Robert Pattinson was kind of too small to be Batman, because he's kind of a thin, slender kind of guy. But and I heard that there was a lot of issues on set with him. All kinds of rumors. I mean, I don't know if any of that's true or not, but apparently he was hard to work with and all kinds of stuff. But so as you could see, you know, you have pictures of the Batmobile. They showed new pictures of the suit, but then there's Selina Kyle up there on her motorcycle. This one is really what caught a lot of people's eye. And we'll go to a bigger picture of it here. So this is what the Riddler is going to look like. And it's weird. It's definitely weird. So it looks to me like something at the end of Pulp Fiction. If you've not seen Pulp Fiction, you should probably go watch it. Or at least YouTube the ending. It looks just weird. That's all I'm going to say about it. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, so a lot of people are saying it's been inspired by the Zodiac Killer. And if you actually scroll down, there has a picture here of what the Zodiac Killer wore. And it does make sense. It definitely looks like it's inspired somewhat. Now, in the trailer, when I first saw it, it looked more to me like he had his face duct taped, because you could see here like there's lines. I don't know, it looked like he had his whole face like duct taped and then had glasses over his head. So I don't know. It's again, so like this tweet here, it's fairly obvious that the Riddler in the Batman is inspired by the Zodiac Killer, and that's fine. It has a certain intimidation factor to it, but it still looks dumb, mainly because the Zodiac Killer looked dumb as well. So good job. I'm sure Paul Dano will be excellent. I'm assuming that's the actor that is playing the Riddler. I think what it comes down to at this point with this is that if the actor pulls it off and they film it well, the mask won't be a big issue. It just has to be executed well for this to look menacing. So, I mean, if I saw this in an alley at night, just this creepy dude or whatever, I can understand this might being put a chill down your spine. But if it's filmed wrong, this is going to look really dumb. So, I don't know. We'll see. Like I said, it just depends. If they're going, it definitely seems like it's a darker tone in this movie, which I like those movies. I've said that many times before. So, I don't know. I haven't ruled this movie out. I'm not super excited about it. Like I've already said, I'm not a big fan of the year two Batman. I like Ben Affleck's Batman, the PTSD Batman, the one who's already been established, his kind of been through the ringer. That's what I want to see more of. I'm tired of the new Batman, but you know, we'll see. I'm not, like I said, not writing it off, but I'm just gonna take it one day at a time and as it is, and not have too high hopes. So if it does surprise me, fantastic. And then if it completely bombs, then I kind of expected it. So I don't know. Yeah, so again, let me know in the comments below what you think. How do you feel about this this Riddler's look? How do you feel about this movie in general? Do you have any desire to see it? I know a lot of people have some angst about, you know, with Warner Brothers, and me too. I'm not a fan of Warner Brothers and what they're doing and what they've done, but number one, they just got sold, which I find hilarious that a lot of those higher-ups are now scrambling and in panic mode. But yeah, my thing is, if it's a good, well-written story, it stays true to, you know, and it respects the fans and whatnot, and it's not woke or pushing any type of crazy politics, you know, I'll give it a shot. I'm not, you know, especially with how everything is right now in Hollywood, you know, I'm gonna support the good things, and I'm going to not support the crap. So I don't know. Like I said, let me know in the comments below what you think, if you plan on seeing this, or what you think about the Riddler. If you like this video, go ahead and please hit that like button. I would greatly appreciate that. And until next time, I'll catch you later.